Here's my promise. In the next 10 minutes, you'll be able to retouch your video, adjust the video position, something like this.
We'll use OBS Studio. So if you don't know the software, just watch this video here, where I will provide you with the essential information that you need to know in order to get started with it immediately. As you can see, by far this shot is not perfect. The light is not so good, I'm a little dark. I have a part of a window here that I would like to hide. That's a part of my green screen with a shadow that doesn't look so nice. You can also see a little part of my microphone, and also the lights are casting many shadows on my face and behind me. So let's see what we can do to improve it. As a first thing, I want to crop the image and resize it to eliminate the objects that I don't want to be in my shot. I click on Alt, go on the little square. As soon as this double arrow appears, I left click and I drag until I'm satisfied. Now at this point, I have eliminated the objects I didn't want from the shot, but now the camera shot is too little compared to the full frame that will actually go to Zoom or Teams. What I can do is click on the source. When the red squares appear, I will take one of them, left mouse click, and then drag until I reach the desired dimensions. Now, the dimensions are good vertically, but horizontally, I'm still missing something. I don't want to uncrop this side, otherwise the window will be back into my shot. So what I can do is further zoom in until I've filled all the area of interest. What you're seeing here with the gray diagonal bars is a portion of your shot that is still there, but it's outside of your area of interest. So it will not be sent to Zoom. Your video conferencing audience will not be seeing it. I think I'm pretty good positioned from the second button of the shirt and also above my head. I don't have much space. And if you're wondering what your position should look like on video conferencing, check my tutorial here. I now want to improve the quality of the image. So for reference, let's take a screenshot of this one. And let's put it close to me so we can compare the effects of what we will do. To improve the quality of the video, we can configure the properties of the webcam. To do that, we right-click on USB webcam, so on our source, and go to Properties. This is the same dialog box that appeared when you created the source. From here, you click on Configure Video. A control panel appears where you can configure all settings. There's a number of them, but we will focus only on what we need. Let's move this a little bit to the side, and let's put the control panel here. The first setting is brightness. Brightness is used to brighten the whole image. With it, you can adjust the highlights and the shadows of an image equally. Let's see what's the impact on my image. Let's increase the brightness. And now let's decrease it. So highlights and shadows are brought up or down equally. Let's return to default. Contrast separates the brightest and darkest area of an image. For example, increasing the contrast will result in brighter highlights and darker shadows. And let's see the effect by increasing the contrast and decreasing it. Let's reset it to default. Saturation is similar to contrast, but instead of separating highlights and shadows, it separates colors. And let's see the effect. More saturation, less saturation. Let's put it back to default. Now white balance. Different types of lights have different colors, from warmer that tend to be orange to cooler that tend to be blue. White balance adjusts the temperature of the color to make it look more natural. By default, white balance is automatic. If we unclick it, you see that we can adjust that manually. Unless you have any specific reason, I would leave this in auto mode. We'll skip hue, sharpness, gamma, and backlight comp. The last setting of this tab is gain. Gain amplifies the signal that is coming from the sensor of your camera. To be noted that it amplifies the whole signal, including noise. Let's try to amplify it. And that's the effect. Let's go to the second tab. Depending on the camera you have, you may have many more options here, like zoom, focus, and so on. With my webcam, I only have exposure enabled. Exposure is the amount of light that is allowed to hit the sensor of the camera. In a proper shot, no level of brightness will go above the absolute white, and no level of shadow will go below the absolute black. If too many levels approach the absolute white or absolute black, then your image will result overexposed or underexposed. By default, exposure is set to auto. You may leave this box ticked, but in certain cases, it's worth adjusting it manually. So let's untick it and see the effect. You're not seeing me anymore because we're not allowing enough light to reach our sensor. We do that in digital way with the webcam. If we now increase the exposure, you see that many highlights approach the absolute white and our image is overexposed. Let's put this back to auto. I suggest the first thing to do if you don't have to do big adjustments is start playing with the gain. Let's increase the gain. That's already much better. We can increase the brightness, increase the contrast. If I increase the gain too much, then I'm definitely overexposed. With the gain level of 22, I see that there is no white area on my face and also the blacks look pretty good. We can play with the saturation to give a little of a different tone to my skin. And this goes according to your preference. This is a bit warmer. This is colder. Maybe like this looks good. I increase the gain a little bit. Let's see how it looks compared to the initial picture. And let's put it here at the bottom to compare. The whole shot is definitely brighter. There are less shadows and my skin tone looks better. One thing to keep in mind is that each camera is different and each lighting condition is different. So the adjustment that I've shown to you are specific to my case. What you'll have to do is open your camera settings and fine-tune them until you've found satisfactory results. My suggestion, if that works for you, is that you leave white balance and exposure in automatic mode and then you start by playing with the gain. If you are in a slightly low light condition, then you may want to increase the gain, increase the brightness, and increase the contrast. You can then adjust the tone of your skin with the saturation. However, if you are in more extreme cases of low light or overexposure, then you can play with the manual exposure settings. For low light, you will choose a higher exposure. If instead your shot is overexposed, then you will reduce the exposure. This is where we've started from. We have then eliminated the part of the window here and my part of green screen, as well as my microphone. So we got to that point here, and then we improved the video quality and got to that point there. The only thing that we need to do now to send our video to Zoom or Teams is to start the virtual camera. That's it, can you believe it? It's your turn now. Let me know how it goes. And if you have any question or comment, just post it here below. If you like this video, you know what to do. What you can do for you now is to watch this video here to learn another tip to further enhance your video conferencing skills. See you in the next Digital Tip.